When weather forecasts are inaccurate, we usually change our plans with little consequence in the greater scheme of things. When economic forecasts are inaccurate, however, the consequences may be huge and significant. While making financial decisions does involve some guesswork, an educated guess, even with elements of uncertainty, may be better than making a decision with no forecast whatsoever. Hey there, Kenner French with VastSolutionsGroup.com. This is a quick brief, and it should provide a basic understanding of economic forecasting. Fortunately or unfortunately, economic forecasting, like weather forecasting, is far from an exact science. Even professional economists may strongly disagree on the direction of the economy at any specific time based on their interpretations of conflicting economic indicators. Although many factors are pivotal in assessing the economy, let's focus on two key points that better help you potentially understand where our economy currently stands and where it may be headed into the near future. So about consumer economic forecasters who are always searching for storm clouds that might signal an economic downturn, since consumer spending has historically accounted for two-thirds of the economy, according to the U.S. Bureau of Economic Analysis, or BEA. Many observers have looked to, quote, pocketbook issues in search of primary clues about the direction of the economy. Now, consumer cutbacks on spending are not usually the primary cause of a recession, believe it or not. Rather, consumers may buy more on credit, which leads to greater monthly payments. But at some point, consumers can only spend what their incomes will allow. When consumer debt rises, it becomes particularly important because of the impact of total consumer spending on our economy. It may also help to understand the federal decisions that lay the foundation for our overall economic climate. The role of the Federal Reserve, or what's called the Fed, you've probably heard. Even the casual observers of business news knows that really Fed watching is a serious activity in the financial and business sectors. You may be wondering, what is it that makes the Fed so crazy important? Well, while consumers affect the economy by economic spending according to their own situations and financial pressures, Fed policy decisions such as fiscal and monetary measures also have an effect on the economy. Fiscal policy, which is enacted by Congress in the form of tax and or spending legislation, is a result of the political process and the prevailing political climate of the day. In contrast, monetary policy is the responsibility of the Fed, whose role is to evaluate all factors influencing the economy, either individual, market, and government, and to take action in attempts to keep the economy on an even keel. The Fed can manipulate the flow of money in order to obtain a desired effect over time. However, the Fed's most effective short-term policy decisions that manipulate the economy involve short-term interest rates. Consequently, the Fed can realistically have really only one target, inflation. If the Fed perceives that the prevailing forces will increase inflation, it can attempt to slow the economy by raising short-term interest rates. You've probably heard about that. It does this based on the assumption that the increase in the cost of borrowing is likely to dampen both personal and business spending per se. Conversely, if the Fed perceives that the economy has slowed too much, it can attempt to stimulate growth by lowering short-term interest rates, the theory being that the lower cost for borrowing may stimulate more spending. The Fed walks a fine line in trying to maintain this balancing act. If it doesn't tighten the reins soon enough by raising interest rates, it runs the risk of uncontrolled inflation. If it fails to loosen them soon enough by lowering interest rates, the economy could plunge into a recession. An argument could be made that the primary goal of the Fed is to keep inflation low enough that it does not affect business decisions in any way. Now, let's talk about personal debt. By observing your own spending and debt burden and that of your friends, relatives, and business associates, that you may potentially gain some insight in the short-term future of the economy. While by no means the whole story, well, this segment comprises a significant chapter since it is, well, the one factor that consumers exercise the greatest control over. When combined with a little judicious Fed watching, i.e. several interest rate moves in some direction versus another direction, you could see if the Fed is on a mission or not. You may have a fairly good basis for general economic forecasting and appropriate financial decisions. Hope this quick brief help you to understand economic forecasting. After all, it's essential to helping your business to grow. With some type of a basic kind of understanding of the economy, it should be a little bit easier to do forecasting for your business. If nothing else, I guess you can seem smart at a cocktail party or whatever. Once again, Kenner French signing off, VastSolutionsGroup.com. If you have any questions, give us a call, 888-808-827.